We're standing at one of the places I most love in this world. There's a big surprise right behind me. You can't tell it standing here. What you see is a line of oak trees, and then beyond it, it looks like flat ground. Well, come with me.
We're in an off-limits part of Terea State Park. Here, we're searching for salamanders in a uniquely Floridian environment.
This is one of Florida's great natural treasures, and one that most Floridians don't know about. It's called a steephead. And to understand what a steephead is all about, we have to go down into it. This is a 45 degree angle slope, and the sand that I'm sliding down on with leaf litter on top of it is at its angle of repose. Any steeper and it'll slide. There's an underground lake back there. Where the slope intercepts it, it leaks out and carries with it sand grain at a time. That little creek is carrying this material away with it downstream. This is fast enough that over 50 years, this little part of the steephead has migrated, oh my goodness, what's that, about 20 feet? There are so many wonderful things about steepheads. We can't recount all of them, but because they're steep-sloped and they're difficult to get into, they weren't heavily logged. They tell an ecological story of wonderful significance.
There are many plant and animal species that are only found in the Apalachicola Bluffs and Ravines region.
There's something here that is really one of my favorite stories. If you grab a leaf and crush it, it's got a really powerful, pungent odor. And it's only found rooted in this kind of seepage in ravines in the panhandle. It is one of the oldest angiosperm, meaning flowering plants in the world. This is called star anise. Right there. There you go. You get up. This is a girl.
How do you tell?
Because of her size of her head. Males have a really big head with big jowls. They fight. I found him in 1960s and named him in 1972. This is the Apalachicola dusky salamander.
Without much effort, Dr. Means turns up a few more.
Oh, this should be a good. And he's lost his tail. Something bit it off. And he's regenerating it. See the little new piece of tail tip coming on there?
The tail shape helped Dr. Means determine that the Apalachicola dusky salamander was a separate species from the southern dusky.
One of the characteristics of this salamander, it has a really long, terete, filamentous tail. When we go look at their relative, the one that's declined, the southern dusky salamander, you'll find out they have a very deep blade-shaped tail, which is one of the differences between them.
Another difference is hard to see when both salamanders are covered in muck.
Although this salamander looks dark, against light leaves, she'll lighten up and you'll see a beautiful little pattern of blotches on her back. Oh, there's eggs, salamander eggs. And you can see little baby salamanders in the eggs. Can you see the salamanders? I was the first biologist to study animals in these steepheads. No biologist knew what a steephead was until I started studying the salamanders and steepheads and writing papers about them. And realizing biologically and geologically how unique steepheads were essentially not in the scientific literature. And what's really cool about steepheads is they are so unique and so found only in Florida, North Florida, especially Panhandle Florida, that the only other place in the universe that they've been found is on Mars.
From steephead ravines to seepage slopes and dark and mysterious swamps, Bruce Means has shown us that one of the best ways to get to know North Florida wetlands is to get down and dirty and go salamander hunting. For WFSU, I'm Rob Diaz de Villegas.